Beatrix, at Siemens Energy, you just announced Born Connected 3.0. What's Born Connected 3.0?
Born Connected 3.0 is our renewed and expanded commitment to our customers to provide them with their substations, or for the substations, for all products meanwhile. So the transformer, the high voltage switchgear, the circuit breakers, bushings, instrument transformers and coils, to provide for the full equipment, the digital layer. That essentially means that all products are digitally connected to the cloud. And two of them, the transformer and the switch gears, are also provided with digital twins. From an historical point of view, and being a physicist, it's the first time that you can measure a transformer in performance in real time in the cloud. 3.0, it's all our products being digitally connected. We have thereby founded the basis for the Internet of Energy.
Now, for the years I've been involved in the energy industry and transmission technologies, the transmission grid has been seen as a bit slow around digitizing. It's not been the fastest, but that's changed in the past couple of years. Why? What's changed?
As always, a change is driven by a technology that cannot be, which is essentially disruptive, easy to use and applicable, and cannot be avoided.
What I would also add to what Dr. Natta said, the challenges faced by the TSOs are also kind of getting more difficult, because they have to add a lot of renewable energies and decentral sources of power. On the other hand, a lot of aging equipment is there in the grid networks, which will get obsolete. Plus, there are also a lot of workforce. It's a lot of knowledge. It's a very knowledge-intensive industry, which will phase out in the next years. So what they need is, they need to attract young people. They need to add a lot of new assets into the grid networks. And all these complexities are really, really making them think what in a very systematic manner, how to bring digitalization into their networks.
Mm-hmm. And we are deeply convinced the only one and the best one who can achieve this and provide this Internet of Things solution, this digital layer on top of the industrial product, on the transformer, on the switchgear, is the OEM, the original equipment manufacturer.
In terms of the Sense products that you've just announced, can you share some examples of what this kind of, what these products are?
Yeah, so first of all, as Dr. Natta mentioned, all our products today are connected. So they have certain basic features by default. So we know where these products are. We know how they are behaving on a real-time basis, if they are overloaded or not. And if these units get overloaded, they also start to lose their normal productive life. So we give them a high-level loss of life calculations. And we also, these assets have a lot of dependency on the weather conditions. So weather plays a very important part when you run the grid networks. So they also come with a 7 days weather forecast. So I think with the basic layer, it's already helping our customers to better understand and better manage the substations. Also, to add, the renewable industry, for example, today with all our products being connected, especially the transformer and the switchgear, they have infinite possibilities now. They can, what we call the combination of a transformer and a switchgear, it's called balance of plant. And this balance of plant, they can really be ready for withstanding dynamic loads.
When I look at what you announced last week, there's a lot of technologies under the covers. You've got AI, neural networks, digital twin, cybersecurity. That's all under the covers.
Yes, absolutely. And important is to talk about cybersecurity, because it is the fundamental topic for us. That means any product we bring to the market as Siemens, we have to have a mandatory compliance to the Charter of Trust. We are one of the founding members of Charter of Trust. We take this topic very seriously. We continuously invest. We are also front runners in many of these technical bodies like IEC, IEEE, where we are ourselves bringing these ideas to these technical bodies to even come and mandate standards, which are really necessary to have more and larger cloud adoption and Internet of Things adoption in the entire transmission industry.
In our industry, there are two types of data. There are data being used to control and protect the grid, which are, of course, extremely, extremely critical and not to be, brought to any cloud. However, there are tons of data which we in the past didn't even get to the extent we can do that now. And that's exactly the ones we are taking and sending to the cloud. Most of our customers, TSOs, meanwhile, have highly secured private clouds anyway. And all they have to do is, once they have a product from us, bring it with its digital layer into the private cloud and do whatever they like. If they need help, we are happy to help, but it's their decision and also their infrastructure.
Now, an angle I had not thought of was that with all of these technologies and connectivity, because of the more efficiency of the overall system, there's a whole lot of different environmental aspects that you bring to the transmission networks.
Mm-hmm. Yes, in terms of better efficiency, of course, but all and reliability, but also of improved business cases.
What you see over the 2 years, Kevin, we are systematically adding intelligence to our products. Today, we are initially we started disrupting the classical or bringing a paradigm shift on the classical OEM market. Today, you look at the high voltage substation with the Born Connected 3.0, the substation starts to convert into an intelligent data hub. And without talking more, we have big plans. We have a solid commitment to digitalization, and we will continue to go with the journey even much stronger and with far more excitement, which we have it up our sleeves right now. We will not discuss that, but we have big plans.
So a lot more for the Internet of Energy,
yes,
built on a secure,
yes,
digital layer.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.